Tonight on Felt Focus, we head out hunting with the experts. How do wasps provide for their offspring? How do black herons get by without sunglasses? And what happens when South Africa's version of Wile E. Coyote runs out of luck? Good evening, and welcome to this week's installment of Felt Focus. To get things started, we share with you this video of a thread-waisted wasp in the process of storing paralyzed grubs in a hole in John Hartman's wall. The busy little female buzzes back and forth a few times, squashing the fat green larvae into what will become the birth chamber for her offspring. She would have already laid an egg in the cavity, but how does she keep it safe while it develops? Watch as she carefully carries mud back to the hole and begins to pack it closed. Even more amazingly, she returns with small stones and expertly places them into the mud like a bricklayer. If the mud starts to dry out, she fetches water and drizzles it onto the opening while she works. Last but not least, she smooths it over so the chamber lies flush with the wall, concealing its presence from potential robbers. It is really incredible how such a primitive little creature can carry out such intricate tasks. Did you know, there are about 30,000 different species of wasp in the world, most of which are actually stingless and completely harmless. It seems that John Hartman has been very busy with his video recorder this holiday, and he also filmed this black heron peering through the murky water in search of fish and frogs. But how it overcomes the obstacle of the glare of the water is truly genius. It uses its black wings as a sun visor, shading the spot that it's staring at so that it can see into the water. This strategy has the added benefit of actually luring prey into the shade of its wings. It checks in different areas of the pond, and after the bird is satisfied that there are no tasty treats hiding in the shadows, it moves on. It does appear like it's playing a slightly silly game of peekaboo, but it obviously works for the bird, as it gobbles up plenty as it goes. What an entertaining sight. Now this malachite kingfisher is yet another one of John Hartman's great entries, but this little bird relies more on its physiology to compensate for the glare of the water. They have a special layer in their retina that allows for the refraction of light. It has found a great perch from which to spot little fish, which it spears enthusiastically with its perfectly adapted beak. It then bashes the unfortunate fish on a branch before swallowing it whole. After a hearty meal, however, the indigestible remains have to go somewhere, so it regurgitates them as a pellet. On closer inspection, we can actually see the fish scales and aquatic insect remains. Then, the bright little bird darts off again to continue its busy day of fishing. Now, seeing a python swallow a meal is always a fascinating sight, and Maria Sneeman caught this 4-meter monster in the process of gulping down a rather unusual meal near Hartbeespoort Dam. It has managed to ambush a young jackal and make short work of the usually alert little canid, swallowing it fur and all. Pythons are not venomous snakes, but once prey is in their grasp, their powerful, muscular bodies constricted easily, squeezing the air out of their lungs, making it impossible for the animal to breathe in. This last photo has the element of finality about it, as the little jackal's foot disappears down the great snake's throat. Did you know? Alongside crocodiles, snakes have the strongest stomach acid of any animal, enabling them to digest things like fur, horns, and hooves. Well, that's all we have for you tonight. But let's part on a slightly less gory note with this set of photos sent in by Rodney Cotton. This young elephant bull is clearly having a whale of a time as it enjoys its bath routine. It flicks and sprays mud from head to foot and then uses its back legs to rub and scratch the hard-to-reach places, shaking its head and waving its trunk in sheer enthusiasm. The cooling effect of the mud and the energy of youth give this elephant the look of a teenager that's up to no good. But I guess boys will be boys. Thanks for watching, and remember to keep sending us all your animated wildlife moments that you catch on film or photograph to info@5050.co.za or PO Box 417 Lyndhurst 2106.